Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Today we will talk about Jahan Devi, one of the great educational thinker. Dear students, this lecture is for class 12th. Dear students, this Jahan Devi was born in America in USA in 1859. Dear students, he was born in a poor family. He was the son of a shopkeeper. But my dear student, due to his contribution as and deeds, he is now been counted in the rank of great educationists in the world. My dear student, this Jahan Devi, according to his philosophy, this education should develop all those capacities in an individual. That makes him to control the environment and fulfill his possibilities as well. Dear students, his philosophy is based upon the evolutionary approach of Darwin and pragmatism. My dear students, he reported that this his philosophy should not be aloof from the usual day-to-day life, but should be applied in the various hospitalized education, social, economic, and other problems as well. My dear students, his idea of this, what I should say, the philosophical idea is that this education is that is actually the process of living through the continuous reconstruction of experiences. My dear students, his philosophy has been viewed variously, like in his philosophy has been talked in various terms, as like one is instrumentalism, this pragmatism, like practicism, progressism, operationalism, etc. My dear students, keeping the aims of this very particular philosopher in concern, his aims, he talks about the and reported about the ultimate aims of education, that there should be growth and more growth. And more importantly, he talks about that the education should be, it should, there should be the continuous reconstruction of this operationalization of experiences. That is the, it should be the basic aim of the individuals of the society. Dear students, according to him, the curriculum of the schools, it should not be rigid and should be based upon the child approach. That is, the curriculum should be according to the interests and positives of this very particular child in the school, keeping the this role of teacher in the school. According to him, the role of teacher should be, it should be positive. Teacher should be like the friend. He should guide the students, keeping the practical aspect of this very particular society in concern. He should help the children to develop their activities and make them aware about the societal problems or social complications that are prevailing here. He should be a kind of supporter, a true guide as well. Dear students, this very particular philosophy of Jahan Devi, this is actually based upon the pragmatism. This is based upon the practical way of life. He morely and in most importantly, he conceived on practical approach, pragmatism, and experiences above all. This experience, he was not approaching the idea of this idealism, but according to this very particular philosophy, he reported that if there arises any kind of idea, thought, whatever, but it should be based upon the consequence. As in the previous lectures, I talked about that the theory without practice is blind pursuit. Similarly, he talks about any kind of thought, whatever that arises in your mind, that came in your mind, it should be applied to the society, to the societal problems. The kind of, there are so many educational, social, political, whatever kind of problems that are prevailing, but you should apply, there should be the applied part, there should be the kind of practicism as well. This is necessary according to this very philosopher. He was not approaching the ideal base. He was not the idealist. I should say he was totally conceiving upon the practical aspect of the society. Dear students, we will talk about some other views in the next lectures as well, my dear students. There is much about this very philosopher. If we will just here discuss the things of this very particular philosopher, what he said, what he reported, what kind of ideas he just proceeded in various what I should say aspects, that is much enough to discuss. But we will discuss this within the passage of time in previous in next lectures as well, my dear students. Thank you.